gentlemen, welcome to the Detro Comedy Room. And now, wait for you.
Great. Look, man, big things coming soon, my friend. Big things. Yeah.
Hey, Drew, you're late. We've been waiting for you to start the show.
Oh, you've been waiting on me? Okay. We'll get used to doing more of that, okay? Yeah. Hold on a second. Hold on. What's that? Oh. Yeah, man, hey, look, we'll meet in the Bahamas on Monday and go over everything, okay? Yeah. Big cheese out. Oh, yeah. By the way, you're going to have to start calling me Big Cheese.
That's okay? Stupid.
Alright, I can do that. Okay, I'm not gonna call you that. Drew, look, now that you're here, is it alright with you if we start the show?
Hey, Mama! Mama! Yeah, hey, did Cousin Terry tell you? Yeah, Mama, all's good, alright? We're gonna be set. I won the lottery, Mama. I won it, we're good.
Did he just say he won the lottery?
Wow, okay, hey, Bishop, I need you to do something for me.
Kill Drew, right?
You want me to kill him? No, that's not what I need at all.
Yeah, okay.
I just need you to go get some information from him, that's all.
Of course, we'll go get some information first, find out where the ticket's at, make it look like an accident, find out he might have, you know, some fetishes, get his dirty laundry out there.
Okay, it's very concerning to me that when I talk to you, you don't seem to understand what I'm saying to you. I need you to just go talk to Drew.
Right. I will talk.
Yes, just have a conversation.
To Drew.
Yes.
We'll have a conversation.
Good.
Accidents happen all the time.
See, that's not
the... Might be showering, soap gets down there, he slips, he falls. He might be into, like, jerking off while hanging himself. You don't know.
Okay.
This guy's got issues. All didn't know about this.
This is really important. This is the important thing that I want you to... That I want to understand, that make sure you understand. Do not hurt Drew. I just want you to talk to him.
Right. I will talk to Drew.
Okay. All right. Lydia, do me a favor.
Kill...
No, killing. The only rule here at Lake here, no killing. Alright, so just go with Bishop, talk to Drew, and everybody come back here alive. Just find out about him when
you're alive. We got you, Wells.
No one dying. Take it away, Dave! Ladies and gentlemen, it's Late Fear with Wills Maxwell! Tonight's special guest candidate for the Board of Education of Hanover County, Kevin Spears! And comedian and founder of Parallelogram, Johnny Gray! And now, your host, the man who cannot properly pronounce Parallelogram, Wills Maxwell! How are you? Welcome to Late Fear, everybody. We're going to have an awesome show tonight. We got a lot of fun. We got a lot of surprises. We're just going to have a lot of fun, guys. I got some really amazing guests. First up, some news. I don't know if you guys saw this, but a wanted man, a wanted fugitive, was recently arrested because he was not happy with his mugshot, so he sent a selfie to the police department. That's entirely true. He sent a selfie to the police department. He's being charged with arson, vandalism, and using too many filters. Using way too many more than what is legal. Guys, good news from Chipotle. They are saying that they might not have E. coli anymore. That's the word they used, might. They're not willing to commit to this. They said they might be free of this. And the thing is, the surprising thing about this is that they've had multiple E. coli outbreaks for months at multiple locations, and they're still in business because people still keep eating there. We've gotten so used to hearing that our favorite foods are killing us that we don't even care anymore how soon it happens. It's like, diabetes, E. coli, we're all gonna go eventually. Why pick? News from today, Sarah Palin has announced that she is endorsing Donald Trump for president. This is really going to help Donald Trump cinch that undecided nut job vote.
I'm crazy, but I don't know who I'm going to vote for.
Oh, the lady that says Obama's going to kill my grandma is voting for the man that says Syrian refugees is going to kill me?
I know where I'm going.
There's some more news about Donald Trump. This is true. Recently in the UK, they had a debate over whether they should ban Donald Trump from coming into the United Kingdom. They had a debate in Parliament for 3 hours on whether they should ban Donald Trump. I'm just telling you guys this so that way you know that if he gets elected, we have at least one safe space. We'll have to go back to the top, but there's one safe space. They didn't take a vote, they just insulted. It was basically just 3 hours of them insulting Donald Trump as hard as they could, which is very fun to watch. Because there's something that's just very sweet about British people insulting folks. I don't know what it is. Like, I didn't know what a Wazzock was until today. I was like, oh, you can't have Donald Trump here. He's such a total Wazzock. I was like, I don't know what that is, but yes, that's exactly what Donald Trump is. He is a Wazzock. They recently announced nominations for the Oscars. For the second year in a row, no actors of color were nominated. People were upset about that. I'm not surprised, because yeah, we had a lot of great roles for black people this year. We had Creed and Beast of No Nation and Straight Outta Compton, but none of those roles were slaves. Black people know, if you want to get an Oscar, you gotta play a slave or a maid. That's the rules. If you're gonna win an Oscar, you gotta play a slave, a maid, or sleep with Billy Bob Thornton on screen. You gotta do something degrading if you want to get that statue. In Moscow today, they're selling a new perfume that is based, the scent is based off of Vladimir Putin. When the scent perfume designer was asked what the scent smelled like, he said, it smells like strength and victory from the crushing the feet of your enemies. Also, lavender. This is very true coming out of Minnesota. A cop has been put on leave because he posted advice on Facebook telling drivers that it is legally okay for them to run over Black Lives Matter protesters. He told them that it is okay for them to run over them and even gave them legal advice on how they can avoid going to jail for running their car over a Black Lives Matter protester. Surprisingly, one of the tips wasn't be a cop. That's why you get away with everything. It's just you do that one thing. Guys, we have a lot of fun today. Last week, President Obama gave his State of the Union address, so it's only fair he said that the State of the Union is strong. So it's only fair that here at Lakefear, since we put a political spin on stuff, is that we do our own State of the Union. So here, helping us out, giving our own Lakefear State of the Union address, our brand new writer, Harper Turk, everybody. All right, Harper, with the State of the Union.
Yes, thank you, Wills. Okay. Everyone excited for this? Ready to find out? This year's State of the Union is... Kentucky! Thank you! Congratulations, Kentucky! Give it up for Kentucky!
I asked him to give a State of... Harper, it was supposed to be longer than that!
Sorry?
You were supposed to give an address. It was supposed to be longer than that.
Oh, sorry. So, 413... East Lincoln Avenue, Kentucky.
Dr. Turk, with the State of the Union address, everybody. Now, we've had a rash of debates recently. We had a Republican and a Democratic debate this past week. We are not able to get the presidential candidates on the show. So what we're going to do for you guys tonight is we are going to have people who represent the presidential candidates. They are going to come up and they are going to defend some of the statements they made in our new segment, In Defense Of. So our first In Defense Of, defending candidates, the words and actions of candidate Ben Carson, Drew Harrison, everybody. Defending the words and actions of Senator Ted Cruz, Lydia Manning. Defending the words and actions of Senator Marco Rubio, Louie Bishop, everyone. And defending the words and action of the star celebrity apprentice, Donald Trump, Harper Turek. Alright guys, so how this works, I will bring up something that a candidate has done or said, and you guys will explain to me, you guys will tell me why that isn't such a bad thing. Are you guys ready?
Ready.
Alright. Drew, we'll start with you. Dr. Ben Carson has said that it is his belief, even though it's been widely accepted knowledge that the pyramids were used as a resting place for the pharaohs, Ben Carson said he believes that the pyramids were actually where they stored their grain. Why is this plausible?
It's very easy. Have you been to Egypt?
No, I haven't been to Egypt.
So what you're telling me is you, a knowledgeable person about political things and actions and statements, do not know for sure that the pyramids are not where the grain is stored.
Well, I've never been to...
Lawyered!
Okay.
Has anyone been to the pyramids? Anybody? Anybody? Exactly.
All right, I guess it's a fair enough point. Harper, Donald Trump, he had released his campaign ad. In the campaign ad, he talked about Mexicans that were storming our borders, and he showed footage of people storming a border, but the footage was not from Mexico, it was from Morocco. Is that an acceptable thing to do?
Of course. He wanted to show the footage of the Mexicans doing it, but the Mexicans stole the footage from him while he was going to take the footage to the footage place. Yeah, in his car, he was driving there, he was stopped by a truck full of Mexicans. They were like, you give us the footage, and of course, since they were Mexicans, they had a lot of guns with them.
Okay.
And so this is the best of my knowledge. They handed over that footage and had to find another like foreign-looking country that has people with guns.
Harper, I feel like we picked the right person to defend Trump. And I also preached One Man Band Dave DeMiro's appropriate sound effects on that. Gonna call One Man Band, everybody. All right. Lydia, we'll move on to you. Your candidate is second in the polls in Iowa right now. Ted Cruz, he is the chairman of the Senate Subcommittee on Space Science and Competitiveness, but he does not believe that climate change is man-made, even though 97% of scientists disagree with him on this. So what is it that Ted Cruz knows that scientists do not?
Well, something that everyone knows about scientists is they're very indoorsy people. They spend a lot of time inside. So how do they know what the climate is doing if they're inside all the time?
Lawyers!
I was outside earlier today.
Okay.
There were men complaining about it being cold. If climate change were man-made, those men would make it warm.
All right, I guess I cannot argue with that. We're going to move on to Harper Turek with Donald Trump. So Donald Trump says recently that the reason we should be suspect of Syrian refugees is he looks at them and he doesn't see any women and children, that the majority are men who look like they could, they're coming to take over the country. Now, the reality is only 22.7% of Syrian refugees are men, so where is Donald Trump getting this from?
Well, the men are the faster and stronger of the bunch, so they're in the front of the crowds. So, when you look at the crowds, you just see the men. The women and children, they're crawling along under the men as they're getting trampled by the men. And that, so technically, like, yeah, he does only see men doing that. And it makes sense.
Okay, that's a...
That's right.
Dave, are these sound effects either positive or negative connotations, or are they just...
No, that just sounds like a rock and roll answer. So
Syrians to the extreme!
All right. I just wanted to know because I couldn't tell if you were upvoting or downvoting these responses.
I have no stake in this thing at all. I'm just trying to interpret it artistically as to help.
Did you write the in between scenes music for the animated Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles series?
I wish I
could.
All right. Moving on to Louis Bishop with his candidate Marco Rubio.
Rubio.
Now, Marco Rubio recently...
Rubio.
Yes.
Now, Marco Rubio was recently citing a historical incident in a comparative relationship with Iran, but he said that the 1979 Iranian hostage did not end
until Ronald Reagan was in office because the Iranians knew we were dealing with someone in charge. The reality of this is that the Carter administration did all the legwork in freeing the Iranian hostages, so why is it that Marco Rubio is kind of shaking in this and giving this credit to Reagan?
Well, what if I told you that the first 20 plays of the Super Bowl had already been planned? What if I told you that?
Okay.
I'm just saying, Marco Rubio pulled the curtain back so the simpletons could see that Big Brother's hands and everything. Iran knew that. Iran knew who was coming in next. Ronald Reagan is a cowboy. He looks good in a cowboy hat. You know who else looks good in a cowboy hat? John Wayne. You know who else looks good in a cowboy hat? Walker, Texas Ranger. You don't fuck with a cowboy when his fucking spurs are jingle jangling. They knew a cowboy was coming in there. You're not messing with a peanut farmer. You're messing with a cowboy. You have any other questions?
No, that was great. And that was a great response. And
it couldn't make it any simpler for you.
That was more coherent than any of the responses given at either debate this week. Thank you very much for that.
All right. Anything you need to clear it up, I'll let you know.
So we're going to move on to some fresh Donald Trump questions. Harper Turk.
Yes.
Harper, recently at a rally last week, Donald Trump. We got some evidence of this that we just need to...
We're not squatting down because Donald Trump wouldn't squat down.
No, he wouldn't squat for anybody.
That's right.
Can we dip the stage lights, please? He kicked off a rally with this.
Howard S. Are you serious? Apologies for freedom. I can't handle this. When freedom brings
answer the call.
On your feet,
stand up tall.
Freedom's on our shoulders.
USA!
Enemies of freedom. Face the music.
Come on, boys, take them down.
President Donald Trump knows how to make America great. Deal from strength or get crushed every time. Over here,
USA.
Over there,
USA.
Freedom and liberty everywhere. Oh, say, can you see? It's not so easy, but we have to stand up tall and answer freedom's call. USA,
USA,
USA. We're the land of the free and the home of the brave. USA. Let's celebrate our freedom, inspire proudly freedom to the world. Ameritude, American pride, it's attitude, it's who we are, stand up tall. We're the red, white, and blue, fiercely free, that's who. Our colors don't run no serene.
Give me a moment.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm good.
All right. Harper, my question to you is, what the hell's up with that?
Okay.
It's ridiculous.
It's a viable question.
Okay.
Well, you know, Donald Trump, you know, today he got his endorsement from Sarah Palin.
Right.
That was that was really the necessary dance. He needs to get summon Sarah Palin, get him on board. He needs something with like a huge burst of over the top patriotism. That's the only way that Sarah Palin will really ever truly like see a candidate as viable. You've got to have like red, white, and blue singers, potentially eagles. I guess they didn't get an eagle. I assume they wanted to get an eagle.
His last experience with an eagle didn't go too
well. That's right. Yeah. I saw that, yes. But I'll defend that next week. I think that perfectly acceptable over-the-top thing that... And he used to secure a very good endorsement from another patriotic thing. I liked it. I did. Did you not love it? You weren't watching it then. You weren't truly watching it. I could watch it again. I could watch it another half time more, if possible.
Harper, I'm really glad you said that. Thanks to the not rowdy for Midnight Players. Guys, I really hope you enjoyed that bit, because I've had that song stuck in my head all for a day. Ladies and gentlemen, now's our time. I'm really excited to bring up to you our first guest. There we go. Our first guest of the night. He's a very remarkable community organizer, doing a lot of big things in New Hanover County and La Porte City. And I'm very excited that he is now running for the Board of Education in New Hanover County. Please welcome to the stage our guest for the evening, Kevin Spears, everybody. Kevin Spears. I have every confidence that whatever we're going to discuss today is going to be healthier for the country than that.
I do believe.
We got a mic for you somewhere. There you go.
Thank you, sir.
How are you doing, man? How are you feeling?
I'm doing great, man.
Good. Doing all right.
Good to see you, man.
Good to see you, too.
Go see Hope.
Yeah, absolutely. We went to school together. Now, I saw that yesterday you got to be in the, you were in the MLK parade. How did that go?
It was, man. Great. It was great, man. Hey, my son with me, little brother, my little sister, we were in 2015 convertible Mustang, just hanging out.
Awesome.
Just hanging out, waving, you know. Great stuff.
That's really amazing. Now you've been very involved in the community, been doing a lot of things. You're running Peace for the Poor, is that correct?
Peace for the Poor, Martin Luther King Recreation Association, what else? Everything else.
Anything, everything that's
little
going
kids
on.
Get thrown out of swing at the park, they call me.
I believe it. He's gonna rush right over and catch the kid before he hits the ground.
My baby fell down at the park.
Okay, I'll be there.
Now, how did you, what was it that made you start getting involved? What was it that to you that made you feel like you, do you feel responsible for the city?
Honestly, man, God.
Yeah?
Yeah, no God.
So it was just something, it was just, you just felt like it was a calling onto you, or?
I used to be one of these kids, man. So, yeah, that's what happened. God. Just kind of
pulling you out of the, now you said you used to be one of these kids. Is this like you're referring to a lifestyle that you felt like, to put it plainly, not too godly?
Godly, I mean, I was raised in the church, but you know, when you're old enough to go a different way, you do that.
Exactly,
so,
okay.
I was old enough to stop going to church and do whatever I wanted to do, that's what I did.
Right.
So, after a long career doing that, I straightened up my life and just one day asked, you know, I wanted to start my career. I'm also a computer technician.
All right.
My major is information technology.
Awesome.
So, I said I wanted to start my career, man. Actually, my career, I started working in the community, so.
That's amazing. No, you mentioned your computer. If you want to get our computers fixed, where do we go for that?
Computer repair.
All right.
That's what happened.
Okay.
I'll be up. I don't work for free.
So kids. But if the kids fall out of a swing, you do that for free. You're not going to charge.
Yeah, I do that for free. I frisk them. Hey, you got it. What do you got? You got some dollar bracelets or something? Yeah, come on, man. Candy apples? What do you got?
That's what makes it safe for you to be on the playground, because you're not on the playground offering kids candy, you're just taking it from them.
Yeah. You can't be just offering kids candy all willy-nilly. That's frowned upon.
So you felt like God was calling you to come be to start your career and to get involved in your community.
He did. He really did, man. That's no lie.
For others that want to get involved, how do we do that? How do you? Because I see you're all over the place. You recently had a blanket and co-drive. How did that go?
It went great, man. I had a bunch of donations.
That's
so
awesome.
I know a bunch of people, so they donated a bunch of things. I gave away a bunch of stuff, but I still had a bunch of stuff left over. So actually, I took it down to the Good Shepherd, and what I had remaining, I gave to the Good Shepherd. But I just. It's a community thing. I know a bunch of people. You know,
man, we buy all this stuff we don't really need.
Exactly,
We wear it a couple of times. A few pictures on Instagram, you can't wear it together anymore. So you have to give it away.
That's what I do. Like, hey, I saw he had that sweater on 13 weeks ago. Look, I can't even wear this sweat anymore.
I hope no one's paying that close attention to me, because we've done 30 episodes. I'm pretty sure I've worn this tie for 20 of them. So
you gotta give that away.
Yeah.
Next week,
you hold up
a tie drive. Give them away a tie next week. You can sign
you,
the back.
You hold a tie drive. I've got some ties for you. Okay. We'll look it up. So for everyone else that wants to do things like that wants to know about all these things that you're doing, or wants to get involved in other things going on in the community, how do they do that? How do they learn about these events, or how do they start something on their own?
It's easy. I was asked that yesterday, and what I encourage people to do is don't look for me. Just start wherever you are.
I like that.
If you see wherever you have a problem at, just start right where you are. Don't go looking for help. If you can help. I promise you, you'll run into me somewhere. You may not know it's me at first.
As long as I've known you, I have thought that you are the closest thing to a real-life guardian angel. Just like, it's like, who was that dude that shook some money in my hand? Oh, that might have been Kevin. Who was that old white guy downtown that gave me some advice? I think that was Kevin.
My man. I dress up as an old white person.
Just get involved.
Yeah.
Now, I'm really excited for this. You recently announced your candidacy. You're running for the New Hanover County Board of Education.
I am.
Now, I don't know if you...
Thank you. Thank you.
Now, I don't know if you've watched our show before. You're alive, so I'm assuming you haven't.
I have. Early show.
All right.
I didn't know you were still doing it.
Oh, no, that's what I get.
I'm just messing.
But I'm a tough interviewer. I throw some real hard direct questions. So now that we're getting into the Board of Education stuff, I'm gonna lay it on you. All right, you ready?
Lay it on.
All right. So you're running for the New Hanover County Board of Education.
I am. That's tough.
Why?
Well, I have a 15-year-old son. He's in 10th grade. It's hard, man. It's hard for students. It's hard for inner city youth.
Right.
You know, so I don't know if we really understand it. But we have 5 failing inner city schools. Mm-hmm. And the schools on the outskirts, they're doing well.
Right.
A's, B pluses, but the inner city schools are failing, man.
Do you feel like a part of that has anything to do with, like, the inner city schools are failing. The racial makeup for those schools are mostly students of color.
Yes.
The schools in this area are, for most part, largely segregated. So do you think the segregation kind of plays into the performances of the school?
Huge.
is huge. I probably shouldn't say that, but it's the truth. You know, I'm not.
Oh, I said it, so it's okay.
It's okay, man. I've kind of, when I started running and meeting people, they were saying you shouldn't say this and you shouldn't say that, and that's not really my reason for running.
Right.
My reason for running is to shed light on the truth.
Right.
So, I mean, it's a problem that we have. Resegregation, there's a huge academic gap between black and whites, and I know a lot of people don't want to acknowledge that there is a black and white thing, but it is, man. We just have to open our eyes and look around us. So
dealing with that achievement gap, what are some things that you would like to see? Like, if you were you going to elect, what are some things that you would like to see happen that can help close that, that would help those inner-city schools?
One thing we have to do is we have to give teachers better pay, better incentives to stay in these schools.
Here's what's gonna happen. I'm gonna ask you that question again, and you're gonna answer that again, and then these guys are gonna applaud because that was the real truth you just said.
Okay.
So we're gonna take that back a second.
Let's do that again.
All right. So dealing with the achievement gap, what are some things that you'd like to see going into the office that we feel like can change that and help out?
We need better pay for teachers, brother.
Let's go to sleep for a second. Teacher pay is very important. We have to help. We have to be able to help our teachers.
Man, there's a high turnover rate for teachers and administrators in these schools.
Right.
So we need something that's going to keep them there. I think you feel passionate about, you know, some people want to be a Joe Clark until you end up in Eastside High. You're like, oh, hell no. I can't do this shit. I don't know how Joe Clark did this.
I don't have nearly enough baseball bats
right.
for this.
You know, somebody wants to yell out, move expeditiously, please. Get the chains off the door. We want to do that. You see, you got some kids, you know, you got kids with a knife, a switchblade,
right.
and a chain around their hand.
And you remember
your name. Like, oh, shit, I'm not Joe Clark. I'm just a regular teacher. Help. Has anybody seen the SRO?
Oh man, I think that's everyone's secret wish that they were really Morgan Freeman.
When Morgan Freeman was young.
Yeah.
And he was 50.
Morgan
Freeman
is
20 right now.
young, past middle age Morgan Freeman.
50-year-old
telling kids to jump off the roof.
Right. I think I want to find that suit that he wore.
He was the sharpest dude, yes. Working in the inner city looking to fly every day.
Wear that suit on election
day. I love it. I have some more questions for you, but some of our other guests tonight also have some questions for you, so I'm going to bring him up.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage our guest comic for the evening, Mr. Johnny Gray, everybody. Excited to have you on.
I'm excited too because I've got a big announcement to make.
Oh, okay.
I am running for Board of School of Education.
No!
Yes, sir.
When did you decide this?
Just a few seconds ago.
Oh, okay. Well, congratulations, I guess.
Yeah. The last thing was December 21st.
You know, you get a dream, and then it gets comes a nightmare.
Yesterday was I had a dream day.
That's our show, everybody.
Guess I'm late on that too.
Johnny, thank you very much for coming on the show. We're excited to have you here. So you said you had some questions on the Board of Education race.
I do, because a few seconds ago when I decided I was going to run for the Board of Education, I thought of some brilliant ideas to help children everywhere.
Well, maybe you can tell them to Kevin. Kevin's still in the race.
I can always steal your ideas and use them as mine.
That would be great.
Be nice.
I don't care. As long as they get out there.
All right, that's...
I can tell people they're my ideas, and people say, you know, 20 years later, oh, you're crazy. That was Kevin. But I'll still say it. Anyway, idea number one, hey, before kids graduate high school, let's make sure they can grow food and prepare it. And if they want to eat meat, they got to kill that meat and then cook it and then eat it. What do you think?
It seems a little...
Sounds kind of survivor-ish.
Yeah.
That's the same.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Like Survivor?
Yeah.
So put kids on Survivor.
Yeah, kind of.
Okay, so
there doesn't have to be cameras. There can be.
So your solution for education is a weird Hunger Games style take. Okay.
Yeah.
All right, any...
Because, hey, what do kids want after they get out of school? Money. What if they need less money because they already know how to make their own food?
That's a good point. It's a fair point. Kevin, use that as much as you want, as often or as little as you would like to implement that. That is up to you. Un poquito.
You have no idea, this is a crazy idea.
No, sorry. What else you got, man?
All right, how about this idea?
Okay.
School starts at 10 a.m. instead of ass butt crack in the morning.
Dave, again, is that an endorsement of what he just said?
Yes.
Okay,
yeah.
All right.
Thank you, Dave. School teacher slash music director.
I thought that was a commercial. It wasn't a commercial?
It's very sweet of you to think we have sponsors.
Oh, okay. We can work on that.
Now, Kevin, with your campaign, where can we find out more about what you're doing, and where can we find out ways to come out and support you and run for what you're doing?
Highly visible on Facebook.
Okay.
I do have a campaign page, Spears for Board of Education.
Spears for Board of Education.
I'm currently building my own website, but I'm black, so it's a little bit behind time. But it's called spearsforschoolboard.org. I've already paid for the domain.
Oh, nice.
I actually made the webpage. I just haven't transferred the files yet.
I've been working on the Lake Fear website for as long as we've been doing the show now, so right. I know how that goes.
Can't wait for those websites, guys.
So I am highly educated, but I'm still black, so I'm just a little bit behind time.
We're gonna close that website achievement gap.
We should.
So Spears for Board of Education on Facebook. Look them up on Facebook. Look them up around town. Kevin, is there anything else you want to get out? Anything else you want to tell these people while you're here?
Vote for Kevin Spears, Board of Education. The early voting starts the 2nd through the 13th, and the primary election day is March the 15th.
All right, thank you very much for that. And bring your IDs. We have voter ID laws now. Bring your IDs, bring your driver licenses. Kevin, thank you so much, my man. It's so good to see you. Thank you for coming on the show.
Bring your IDs or be able to recite the,
The preamble?
The Constitution backwards.
They're bringing civil laws on us now.
Bring your grandfather.
They don't want you to show up drunk to vote. And make sure you're sober.
Bring a little cash. They have a poll tax now. In the words of Donald Trump, we want our country back.
Remember, a vote for Kevin Spears is a vote for Johnny Gray.
Yes, that too.
And his ideals.
Hey, Johnny, did you drop it? Would you like to do some stand-up for us?
Oh, sure. I thought you'd never ask. I thought I was going to have to sit down the whole time.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our guest comic, a very brilliant man and a good friend of mine, the one, the only Johnny Gray, everybody.
Hey. Thanks for saying I'm smart, Willis. I appreciate that. Hey, I know Kevin's probably got a stressful time going on since he's running for a political office, but me as well. It's not all about Kevin. I too am going through a stressful time because I consider myself a comedian, and coming up next month, February, guys, the funniest month, without a doubt. Comedians everywhere, gotta get their shit together to get ready for February. Because not only is it the shortest month, it's jam-packed with hilarious events that should be made fun of. What am I talking about, you might be thinking? How about the Grammys? How about the Oscars? How about that dumbass holiday Valentine's Day? You know it. What about my favorite thing to make fun of? Huge ass sports events. Super Bowl. Who's ready for the Super Bowl?
Keep pounding.
Keep on pounding. Guys, hate to admit it, but I don't care about sports. Watching them, don't care. I like playing them, but I'm not in the game, so I don't care. I don't even know anybody that's playing the game. That would change things if I knew somebody playing in the Super Bowl, but I don't. Care about sports movies, though. Why? Because I get to learn about the people before they play the big game. Develop some love for them. If the Super Bowl had the drama and the character development of Air Bud Golden Receiver, that'd be all about it. Closest thing we got on TV is the Puppy Bowl. And those little bitches don't have a shred of the athleticism as Air Bud. They can't hold the ball in their mouth. Air Bud can grab that ball, run all over the place, not get tackled. I do try to watch the Super Bowl every year to feel like a normal person. And it was super exciting last year, halftime show. You probably remember Katy Perry. Woo! That was a high performance. That performance was so good, made me wish the football to Katy Perry ratio was reversed. And the Super Bowl consisted of all Katy Perry and her sweet ass songs and hot ass dance moves and amazing mind blowing visual effects. And then halfway through, they play football for a little bit. That performance was so great, the backup shark dancer on the left became famous. I follow that shark on Twitter now. Some people watch the Super Bowl for the commercials. And I have learned a lot from watching those commercials, like how to prepare for a Super Bowl party. Step number one, you gotta get Domino's pizza and Totino's pizza rolls. That's number one. Number two, you better get Pepsi's and Budweiser's. Number three, you gotta get Doritos. If you don't have Doritos, you're gonna look like a jackass in front of all your friends. And number four, there's no commercial about this, but I think it goes without saying, you go to your fridge, you take out all your vegetables, all your fruits, and you throw that shit in the trash. I don't know how football became synonymous with food that's terrible for you, but I brought a salad to a Super Bowl party one time, and everybody looked at me all disappointed, like I just peed on the floor. Should have crumpled some burritos on that. That's where I fucked up. I feel like football fans are really influenced by these commercials, and there could be a health revolution in this country if they had just one vegetable or fruit commercial. I know nobody ever makes vegetable or fruit commercials, but it would be revolutionary. They'd have Tim Tebow and a nice orchard chomping on a Honeycrisp apple. That's a good apple. He's enjoying it so much, he points up to God, "Hey God, thanks for this apple, it's really good." And then you hear this booming voice, "You're welcome, Tim Tebow." And then the text comes at the bottom of the screen, "Apples. They grow on trees, for God's sakes." I'm gonna say one more thing and then I'm gonna stop saying things. I think it's weird that the Super Bowl, they announce the winner and they say that winner is the world champion. Even though no other country plays this crazy game, that's a little bit of a cop-out. Kind of reminds me of this game I used to play with an ex-girlfriend where we'd get our butt cheeks together ever so slightly to where our buttholes are touching. Sounds weird, right? But it's pretty fun. Even though it's not even like sexually stimulating, it's just kind of a fun challenge to do with butts. And depending on the size of the butt, that's when it gets more difficult. Anyway, I looked it up on the internet. Turns out nobody else is doing this. So guess what? Butthole punching world champion right here. You're looking at him. Buttholes and buttholes. Imagine that sporting event. I'd watch it on TV. Anyway, that's it for me. Here's Will's Maxwell. Give it up.
Johnny Gray, everybody, get up. Oh, man.
I'm not done. I thought I was done.
No, man.
Cool.
Now we gotta learn about you. Because we still have it somehow.
Excuse me.
I think you broke it, man. No, I'm just
okay. I won't be responsible for that.
Thanks so much. Well, the crow's dead. You're not going to do anything worse to it.
You know, you're right.
Yeah.
Huh.
Throw that on the ground. No, that's what. That was a great performance, man. Thanks so much for coming on the show tonight.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Now, you brought up something that I know for a bit. You eat very healthy. You're probably one of the healthiest eaters I've ever known. Why? Why is it so important to you?
I'm the healthiest you've ever known?
I probably.
You've never even seen me eat, though.
That's the thing. That's why you're so healthy. I've never seen Johnny eat. so healthy.
Well, to be honest, I've eaten before.
Okay. Anorexia is not good, kids.
Uh-uh.
All right. So.
Yeah. I eat food. I like food.
That's good. I don't know if you've seen the show before, but I asked them really tough interview questions.
Yeah, you said that earlier.
Yes.
Now I'm feeling
You're in the hot seat now.
So I'm on this food diet.
Yes.
It's not a diet. It's just what I choose. I have decided not to buy meat. But I'll eat meat.
Oh, okay.
If somebody hands it to me.
So you're
what?
So you will succumb to meat peer pressure.
Yeah, if I'm hungry and it's already dead and cooked.
Yes.
And in my face.
And someone hands it and waves it in front of you. Yes.
Yeah.
But you will not fork over the money to big meat.
No.
Okay. All right. I rescind my statement about you.
But how often does somebody just hand you meat?
That's not often enough, so it's kind of a holiday for you, I guess. It's just kind of a...
And it does happen a lot on the holidays, yeah.
Are you a big fan of the Air Bud franchise?
No.
No?
Yeah.
I love that.
Is that disappointing?
I just thought I had
a... Sorry, I lied to everybody.
Yeah. That's what this is what this interview is going to be. I'm just going to debunk everything you said in your stand-up.
Well,
so do you really hate Valentine's Day?
Did I say I hated Valentine's Day? I think I said I like to make fun of Valentine's
Day. Okay.
So therefore I love Valentine's Day.
Okay. So that's a true statement about your statement.
Yep.
How did you get into comedy, man? What was it that, because I like watching, you're a very unique performer. What was it that got you into performing?
I think narcissism.
Is that because I feel like that's what gets all of us in it, right?
Yeah, I think so.
It's like, I'm funny, so I think I'm funny, so other people are going to think I'm funny too.
Everybody look at me.
Yeah. No, that's totally it. You do improv and stand-up, though. What fuels your narcissism more? Is it being on stage or creating something off the cuff or presenting your prepared material to people where it's just you on the stage?
Well, those are very two different... I almost consider those sports. Like,
okay,
stand-up would be singles tennis.
Mm-hmm.
And improv would be
double
basketball.
Singles? Okay, basketball. If you have a two-man group.
It could be double.
It's double.
Depending on how many people you got up there.
So, singles tennis, that's a more narcissistic sport than basketball.
Oh, I guess so.
Like, if I have to compare the egos of Maria Sharapova to LeBron James.
Mm. You're right. Okay. It's hard to measure egos.
It's hard to measure.
Science hasn't come up with a specific barometer of that.
So I met you over at, when I started doing comedy at Maxwell, I met you over there.
Mm-hmm.
So you've been doing this, you've been in this for a few years now. Are you getting like what out of comedy what you thought you would get? Are you getting, what have you learned that's different than what you thought it would be before you started doing stand-up?
I think I've learned that I needed a lot of work to be good at it.
Yeah, that's a surprise for all of us, right? Because because it's a narcissism that gets us to start doing it.
Mm-hmm.
You're like, I'm funny, everyone else is going to think I'm funny. And then you realize, like, oh, this is an actual craft.
Mm-hmm.
This is an actual thing.
Yeah. And every little word matters, and facial gesture. All the details.
How long did it take you? Because I've never seen anyone that performs quite like you. You've got a very natural, loose manner.
Arm swinging. Yeah.
How long did it take you to develop that style to learn that you should be swinging your arms?
I had to go to college for that.
I believe.
I think certain things develop naturally.
Right.
And I think that might be one of the things that is honed by nervousness and the constant question of what do I do with my hands?
That's very true. Yeah, that's very.
You gotta do something with them.
Yeah.
Yeah, just let them dangle there.
Now I mentioned that you do improv. You run an improv show here Wednesday nights, is that right?
That's correct.
Yes. Now tell us a little bit about this, because I've been in it once. It's a lot of fun. Tell us a little bit about the show.
Well, I think it's a pretty cool one as well. It's called The Jam, and it's at the end of improv night here at the Dead Crow Comedy Room on Wednesday nights is the improv night. So it happens about 10 o'clock, and we let anybody in the audience that would like to play improv games play some improv games with us.
So if you've ever been interested in just getting on stage, feeling it out, come on out 10 o'clock Wednesday night. And we'll pull you up on stage, and you don't have to be up on stage the entire hour. You just play.
You
up.
Don't have to.
You can come up and just get that one game,
mm-hmm.
And if you want to come back for the next game.
Yeah, there's a little more structure to it, hopefully, than that. But there's a lot of freedom involved in it, which is my favorite thing about improv is the freedom. The more free you are, the more entertaining the show is, and you get to unlock all these creative juices in your brain that you might not even know were there.
I dig that. And you're a fun improviser. I have fun watching you improvise. I have fun improvising with you.
I have fun performing with you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for my guest tonight, Mr. Johnny Gray. Thank you. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that is our show for tonight. Thank you guys very much for coming out. Oh, good. So, have you guys learned anything about what's going on with him? I mean, because he's just been...
Drew is still alive.
He's just... No, thank you for that. I'm glad you didn't kill him. But he's just been acting so weird ever since he won the lottery.
Yeah, I mean, he bought me this cherry limeade. Like, ever since he bought me that, he's been acting like he owns me or something. I don't know.
Would you say the money has really changed him?
Yeah, that's what I said.
Well, I said it into the microphone.
Yeah.
I'll say my thing into the microphone, too. He's so arrogant now.
Would you say that his ego has undergone
inflation?
Yes, he's gotten really obnoxious.
Wait, I'm looking up other money-based words.
I don't know if you guys heard me the first time or not.
We told you.
But he bought me this chain around him like 10 minutes ago. And ever since then, the guy has been acting like he owes me or something. I wanted to put it in the pot, let it marinate for a moment, let the juices get there, come back to it, let you guys know about it.
Okay. No, that's really...
No, it's not okay. We should say something to him.
We should say something to him.
Someone should talk some sense.
Yes, yeah, Harper. Yeah, that's right. Hey guys, look, he's conveniently walking in this direction. It's about time that we teach him a lesson. An economics lesson.
No, it's not okay for the different flavored pieces to be the same color.
True,
okay. I mean, how am I supposed to know if I'm about to bite into a lemon or a banana? I can't take that chance.
Hey, we just want to talk to you.
I don't care what it costs, just make it happen. I love you too, Mom. Yeah, bye.
Hey, Drew, we just...
Oh, sorry. Yeah, I'm off the phone, of course, but I need a second of a long time before I talk to you simply simple things.
Okay, that's it. All right. You can't use the same word different ways three times in a sentence and then think, and then you know what I'm talking about.
This money has really gotten to your head.
Oh, you mean this hat?
No, I mean your attitude, but I guess...
But this hat, right?
Yeah, we'll talk about the hat.
Yeah, got it at old Family Dollar.
Wow, Family Dollar?
Yeah, limited edition. Yeah, they only have 12 left.
Wow, that's... You never would have made such an extravagant purchase before winning...
$5.95.
Yeah. Oh, you won $600?
No one wins $600 in the lottery, okay? I won $5.95.
Well, this entire time we thought you won the jackpot. You know people win, like, hundreds of millions of dollars playing the lottery.
Whoa, no one wins hundreds of millions of dollars. Okay. I see what is happening here. I see. You can't be happy that I'm happy. You gotta make up these outrageous stories about people winning money in the lottery, okay? I won $5.95. Let me be happy about it, all right? You know what? I'm done. I can't handle this negativity.
Man, this entire time I thought Drew won the Powerball jackpot. I can't believe he would to be so flaky and rude to his friends over winning such a small amount of money. I mean, that's just the stupidest thing I've ever heard.
Guys, seriously, shut up. I just won a free fry with my next purchase. Yeah, fucking dead me, I'm out of here.
Okay.
Guys, I just got entered in a chance to take a survey to maybe win a $50 gift card to some place I just heard of. I gotta go do this.
Oh my god, a nickel!
Ladies and gentlemen, that's our show for tonight. My thanks to our guests, Johnny Gray and Kevin Spears. My thanks to the Matt Rowdy for Midnight Players, Tyler Wood, Dave Demir, our one-man house band. I was Maxwell, and this is what I want to do when I grow up. Good night, everybody.